How do you live life and win the game? Well, in spite of all this stuff that sounds so terrible, there are people that seem to be winning, seem to be fulfilled, seem to be making a difference, seem to have a great deal of joy in their life. And they seem to have it consistently. And they're not doing it through drugs or alcohol or distraction. They're doing it through living a life of significance. How have they done it? They do what we do in our Date with Destiny seminar. We accomplish 7 things in that seminar. And I bring it up because I hope you'll take the time and actually come. Well, we'll get your purpose and your mission statement and your values all in the exact order you ideally need them to be, so you're being pulled in the direction you want instead of being pulled in multiple directions. But for right now, here's what we do. And this is what we're going to start doing on this tape. It's the first thing these people have who succeed or are fulfilled is they've decided what the purpose of the game is, at least for right now. Do you follow me on this? They said, okay, I don't know what the purpose is ultimately, but let me just decide. For right now, the purpose of my life is to what? It's to love and be loved. It's to grow. It's to expand. It's to make a difference. Do this. It's do that. They come up with a purpose, which is what I want you to do at the end of this tape. The start. I know it's not the end all and be all from one tape, but I want to get you started on a mission statement, a purpose statement for your life. You got to have that. If you don't at least have a target, if you don't know what the goal of the game is, you don't know what to decide to do. We have all these choices, all these opportunities. So you don't have to choose between something that's good and bad. You have to choose between something that's good and something that's great. But if you don't know what your purpose is, if you don't know what you value most in life, you can't make an easy decision. All decision-making is value clarification. See, if you don't know where you're going, then you can get there by any road. Because you're not going to know the difference. You know, everything looks like a great opportunity. One of the biggest challenges in life is choosing, focusing your life, deciding what to spend your time on, what to spend your energy on. Having a clear purpose allows you to do that. The second thing you want to do to make your life work, and those who succeed do this, is they have fewer rules. The more rules you have about how people have to be and how life has to be for you to be happy, the less happy you're going to be. See, you know, the happiest people are those people that say, you know, every day above ground is a great day. The happiest people are the people who find joy in a smile, joy in adventure, joy in a simple action. See, if you can find joy in that area, then all the big things are just a big bonus for you in your life. So when you find yourself starting to react to something that someone else has done, then you might want to ask yourself, how significant is this really, right? Is this so bad? Is it okay for this person to have a different opinion, a different view, a different feeling than me in this area? And in most cases, you might say, yeah, it is. What would you have to believe in order to be upset? That everybody has to live by your rules? Well, maybe in some areas that's real important. Maybe some other areas it's not as significant. You can just let go of it and have a lot less pain. The third thing that people who win the game of life seem to have in common is they've made their rules consistent. They found the conflicts in their life, and when they find them, they've been honest with themselves and say, this is a total contradiction of what I normally believe in other areas. No more. This is not how I'm going to live my life. Fourth thing these people do that make them succeed is they give themselves pleasure whenever they win, even when the world doesn't. This is really important. You got to realize that sometimes you'll do everything right and you won't get acknowledged. So what? Acknowledge yourself. You got to catch yourself doing little things right and give yourself the pleasure you deserve. After all, if somebody else tells you, hey, great job, and that makes you feel good, it's not them saying great job that makes you feel good. It's when they say great job, you stop and say, oh, that means I get to feel good, and you send a little neurotransmitter that allows yourself to feel the pleasure feeling in your body. Why not just give it to yourself so that you keep yourself on track so you're always reinforcing good behaviors, excellent behaviors, commitments to your highest values? Fifth thing these people have in common is when they screw up, when they don't do things right, when they violate their own values, when they violate their own sense of purpose in life, they give themselves a short burst of pain. They say, hey, this is not who I am. I stand for more. They don't wait for the world to have to give them pain. That's why they're on track. The sixth thing that these people that win have in common is that they know that everybody in life has different rules, and so when they get in a relationship with people, they know they've got to have other people in their life to help succeed in a particular area, they try to find out their rules. Because if you know what's most important to people, if you know what their rules for life are, what their musts are in life, it's a lot easier. And lastly, people who succeed in life, they've learned that life has a purpose, but they also at the same time don't take life too seriously. They don't take themselves too seriously. What's that old funny metaphor? Why do angels fly? Because they take themselves lightly, right? The bottom line is we've got to look at life in a different way.